Only last week, our country, Zimbabwe, became a subject of unmerited focus and debate in the British House of Lords. This British extraterritorial concern by a foreign legislature on a sovereign African state, which is a full and equal member of the United Nations, is grossly unwarranted in terms of tenets of international law and practice. In the ensuing debate by that foreign legislative body with no jurisdiction over our country, a junior minister of Her Majesty's government in charge of Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office, one minister, Tariq Mahmoud, revealed that Her Majesty's government has been meeting in Harare with various trade unions, including teaching unions, most recently in September 2021, on salaries and the impact of COVID-19. To us, this brazen disclosure was yet another confirmation of very gross, unwarranted, and blatant interference in the domestic affairs of our country by the British government, contrary to rules and precepts of the Geneva Conventions, which regulate interstate relations. Zimbabwe is a sovereign state, has been since its independence from colonial rule in 1980, which is not even affiliated to the Commonwealth, a body it voluntarily quit over differences related to a just land reform program. Equally, civic groups and teachers employed by the Zimbabwe government to work here in Zimbabwe are not employees of the British government, whether by contract or by remuneration. Their activities, singly or in combination, have nothing to do with the British government or any foreign government for that matter. Because of this brazen self-confessed violation of our sovereignty and the threat to our national security and stability by the British government, my government will institute full and thorough investigations into this very grave matter.